Oops. Oh, how do I backspace? Oh, circle. I love that, the auto splits. I've never used auto splits before, so it's super cool. I've never been able to get through that intro so fast. Not even remotely close. And the load times, oh my goodness. The load times between the PC version and the Switch are extraordinary. I've also never played with this controller before, so it's gonna be a little touch and go. It shouldn't be too bad. I was wanting to play with the game full screen and like chat on a different monitor over here, but apparently for some reason this game takes decent graphics card, I guess? I don't know. It gets a little laggy if I do it on two different monitors. It might just be because of the monitor I'm connecting to is a television. I don't really know. You don't have to cloud step there. It's not any, as far as I can tell, it's not any faster to cloud step. I think all the aerial maneuvers are actually the same speed, unless you hit an enemy. I think then you bounce off them a little bit. But I haven't timed it. It just seems like you slow down a little bit. I love the music in this game too. I know that can be done in a different way, but I'm not really sure when and where to jump to make it so you don't get hit. So I decided I would do it just a little bit slower to avoid the damage. You can make that jump too. Oh no! Oh no! I missed a gem. Already off to a great start. We're good. So we need this. That is an ability that makes it so we can cancel out enemy projectiles. I think. I'm fairly certain that's what it is. I didn't read the ability, and it's been a while since I played. Made it up anyways. Now that top, I think they're called time shards. I think I missed that one, or I got an extra one that most people don't get. I don't know if it's faster to not get it, but I do know that I need to make up a deficit of a couple. I love the underwater versions of the tracks. They're muddled and fantastic. There's another trick that I skipped back there. Damage boosting through the spikes. Over the moving platform. It's definitely faster, but I'm not good enough to survive the damage reliably, so I'm gonna skip the high damage spike damage boost that I know of on my initial run. I saw a thing in Discord where you can damage boost off those spikes too and get over them. I thought that was pretty cool. I am almost entirely sure I did that slowly. Yeah, because I think that pendulum is in a different spot if you do it quick. Oh, I didn't do that right. Dang. Didn't do that part quite right either. I tagged the wall just a little bit. But I don't expect to get a whole lot right either. Now if I'm smart, I'm pretty sure at the end here, I don't know how many of these time shards you need, but I'm pretty certain in order to one cycle this boss, you need the shuriken upgrade so you can hook shurikens out. Otherwise you miss, and you have to wait a little bit. You know, I just realized that my title on my stream's wrong too. I'm sure of it. Oh well. I don't need that. Okay. Oh, but I didn't grab the upgrade! Dang it. It's gonna be a two cycle. Or at least two attack. The mythical second attack that nobody ever sees from this monster. Yeah. There it is. Mythical 2 cycle. So alright, it'll make the second attempt get really easy PBs. Or at least it'll make it easier. And Autumn Hill Split should automatically end after this drop, I think. Yeah! Awesome! Now, I'm sitting here too, and I'm realizing I've had problems with my chatbot in the past day or two. So, on the off chance that anybody's actually trying to send a message, there's a chance that I won't see it. But I do have my stream open in the background, so I can monitor things. I just can't see all of chat because the game's blocking the way. So if I'm not responding to people, there's a good chance it's because I'm not seeing the chat. It's something I need to fix. But if you spam the chat a little bit, eventually I'll see the messages pile up at the bottom, and then I'll know that I done goofed. I don't think I actually lost much time there, though. But you have to wait on that, other smusher. The more I listen to the Catacomb song, the more I realize I really like this tune, too. Sick damage boost. We got pushed by the spike pusher. Completely unintentional. Oh no! Oh no, I died! That's not good. Okay, so now I need backup strats, because what happens in this game, when you die, you get this annoying cutscene, which actually isn't too bad now, but more importantly, he steals all of your monies. He's a real rude dude. Until you make it up, and I should be making money as I'm going along through here, but now I'm not gonna be, so I'm gonna have to hit extra lanterns and stuff. And again, for all I know, I might actually be ahead on the money anyways. Yep, that was a thing. But that's okay. So if you die again, it just resets the money counter one more time. So it's not particularly nasty. I'm trying to remember which way to go on this game, for the most part. Alright, and I don't have shurikens to help me on this section, so it's gonna go slow for sure. You gotta kill all three of the witch robes. Actually, I think that could have gone a lot worse. They have RNG placement. And, here's another section I'm not going to be damage boosting off of. It's a little slow to wait on that platform, so people skip it. Well, I didn't make it up in one jump, but that wasn't too bad. Making money again, by the way, my little greed demon buddy left me. And I think I might have been able to get that far past the cycle, but I wasn't about to risk it. Terrible. I think this might have health. It does not. What a shame. Oh, boss chamber. That means this has health. Alright, let's go talk to the shopkeep and buy that, and then you buy these two. So I did have enough to buy everything. I don't think anything else is bought during the run. But I could be wrong. I'm probably wrong. Now, somebody I think was onto something. I think if you skip all the chat or things with this new turbo tech skip, I think you get high Ruxton every time. Because I tried this one time, got high Ruxton. And every time I saw Kaningas do this earlier, he got high Ruxton. I think the turbo skip makes you get through the conversation enough, or fast enough, that he always starts high. Which is super cool if that's true. But so far, I'm 2-0 on Ruxton. And that was as far as I practiced, so this area is all, yeah. I think I actually did things slow by going up top. You can jump off the blue dude, spike a ball, and skip up. I did not get that. I think you can. It seems like you can. I'd be really surprised if you couldn't. you can also do this, I think.
Yeah.
That's something I learned off of watching speedrunners. A couple of times that I've been or seen them go through this area. I've also seen an out-of-bounds glitch here, but there's no way I can pull it off. I don't know how it will work well enough. There's a cool way to do that skip too, but I was told how to do it once, but it was several weeks ago now, probably like a month, and I don't remember. It's a real shame. That needs to go. You just fall down this way. And hopefully don't get hit by all the fireballs. Oh, I did that totally wrong. You need to be on this. You get up here. And this one you just fall. Yep. And then this. So like, oh man, I feel like there's definitely a way to do that. That does not involve falling all the way down here. Very carefully fall between all the different platforms. Alright. So, funny thing, this golem is the boss that killed me the most times during my casual playthrough for this area. So. See how that goes. Oh no! Gotta hold the button down. There's a quick boost you can do there too. I think you just mostly fall down this part. Ooh, that was iffy. I think my health is low enough where if I had failed that, I would have just died. I think the spike's still 3 hearts of damage. Definitely grab that. Move on down this way. There's also a way to do a clip through one of these walls too. I'm, not doing the glitch category, though, or the out-of-bounds category, so I better not try to do any of them, even though I don't think I'd be successful either way. There is an upgrade. I don't know when you pick it up. But there's a maneuver of attacking with your blade in the air. I don't know where to do that. How to get that. One spot where you use it to boost up higher than you're supposed to. Maybe I'm crazy. I might be crazy. Get out of here, Wizrobe. Let's double check what the price of it is. I feel like I might be able to buy it. This one. And now, I feel like you don't get these. So I'm not gonna get them. Even though I could. Because apparently I have a ton more time shards than I should have. I got the three. Okay, we're gonna hope. I think it's 7 hits, and then you toss a shuriken. And you damage boost through his leg. It was 6 hits. You toss a shuriken. Get this bad boy. Oh well. If I do this without... Nope, I died. But I don't think it matters on a boss. I think he gets scared away. He's like, oh no! Boss! He's gonna do it right here. Yeah, he's like, oh no! Get me out of here! I'm gonna die one more time. I'm trying to do the strat. So, I know you damage boost through his foot. But I got hit twice. I'm not sure why I got hit twice. Maybe you have to jump so you get damage boosted further. But I think I recall that happening. Let's try that. Maybe you have to... Oh, you know what? I bet you have to damage boost into it backwards somehow? How the heck? I do not know. So I'm gonna skip it. I'll have to pay attention to that. Remember, Golem Boss is gonna do nasty things to me. Six hits. Six hits. Oh no, it is 7 hits. Oh no! I'm gonna lose all this time. That's fine. 7 hits. I must have screwed up the first time I hit him and actually hit him 8 times. And miscounted the whole time. it up. The void. I just wasted all my shurikens. Did I get him? I did not. Okay, and then you stay to the center. Nice. Okay. I got past the green ball. There's a cute little emote that features this dude. In front of your face. So my best time, I did a run offline once. A long while back, when I was playing the game, freshly. And I had a time of like an hour and 30 minutes. I'm already way past that, and I haven't played in ages, so I'm feeling pretty good. I remember there's actually a secret down there. Pretty cool. And then... Oh no, maybe it's not this part. I know there's one skip in this game that I found. Well, I didn't. I wasn't the first to find it or anything. But that. I figured out how to do that in my casual run on my own, because I kept dying at this part. Oh no. That's okay. Like I said, keep dying at that part. I don't remember I can do this glide mechanic now. You don't hit that save point normally. I forgot that it existed. I feel like you can do that. I think you can do it without hitting the enemy. You throw a shuriken at that thing. You time that right so you bounce off both of them. I think there's a fast way up this wall too. And you do some kind of crazy jumps to end up under that. I think you save some time because you're not going up so high. And this part... Oops. I think it's double shuriken. Nobody gets hit on that guy, so I should feel bad. Do. It's something like that, but it's done with the enemy, and it's done a lot better. Those get damage boosted through, and the damage boost lasts long enough to get all the way through the section. I would die. Well, I might not die. Don't know how much damage those things do. Two, maybe? Wasn't too bad, that was smooth. Now for this boss, who also killed me quite a few times in my casual. I did not time that right. You throw the shuriken when she gets on the hook and it knocks her off. And there's one more phase of this. First try. It might not have been fast, but it was first try. I can't complain. My favorite song in the game. Gotta go in here. I got a rope dart. Actually, you know what? Let me double check. I feel like, I could be wrong, I feel like people grab some upgrade that makes it so. Maybe they don't. I'm not gonna grab any because I don't know. Slow. I think you can skip at least part of that. Damage boost through those. You. You do a sweet elevator hop there. Oh man, it's so cool. Anyways, you do. Yeah, you do that. And you hop up there without taking damage. You jump over there, apparently. You do it all talented-like. I love the song. Okay. There is... How do you do this trick? I mean, I know it's done something like that, and you jump up here. But you do it from the other side. Thank you. actually pretty cool. I didn't do it. Oh no! It's alright. At save point. And there's a cool trick you do off this dude. Oh man, first try! What kind of first try? First try enough that I'm gonna take it. And then die. So I'll get another chance to first try it. Whoa! Okay, I did not first try it that time. Not a big deal. Honestly, the trick is probably beyond my skill level to do it consistently. I got up with it. I think you need this. Well, Zacharoni, hey, what's up? Yes, this guy playing some Messenger, trying to speedrun. Doing it, I don't want to say blind, but doing it without much experience at all. Absolutely. And not doing very good at it. I should put this part's been throwing a wrench in things really well. Now okay. I did it that time. And I got hit by the fireball. I died. Eh, you know, whatever. Not a big deal. I know how to get past that part, at least. In a safe way. Which is good, because I did not get the health max. It did used to follow, but I have it turned off right now. Because I wanted to see if I could even stream this game properly. Without it, which is questionable. I don't actually know how well it's looking. It might sound weird, but I mean, I'm doing this all on one PC, and my PC's not super amazing, and I've tried one other PC game, and it caused all kinds of issues for me, so I wanted to make sure that I could even do it first before I tried to enable that extra software burden. Because it actually takes a little bit of processing power, believe it or not. Alright, let's do this right this time. Yeah! Easy every time. This is actually the first time that the camera's not following my face in ages. And the camera's over here now. I keep looking over here to, like, kind of look at it, but that was semi-done correctly. Subnautica and Sea of Thieves. I've never played Sea of Thieves. It looks kind of interesting, but at the same time, it looked kind of interesting, I should say. And not in a good way on that one. I've seen Subnautica. Haven't played it. But it looked more interesting roguelike. For like 2 weeks each. That didn't go too great. But if you go like this. Right, and you gotta bounce behind him. Nice! First try. I like it. It was sloppy. It wasn't good, but I did it. Subnautica has a good story. I think. Is it kind of stylist? I'm pretty sure I think I know what you're talking about. It's a roguelike submarine game, and it's kind of, the artwork kind of reminded me, at the very least, of Don't Starve. I feel like my camera's not looking in the right spot. That's okay. There's some cool way to get up here, too. Much faster than how I did it. I'll take what I get, though. Handling this all kinds of goofy. Made it. Ooh. Some big enemies. I don't know anything. I haven't watched any of the gameplay. I should say that. I've seen like the trailer on. Woo, that was weird. I hovered there. That's not normal. I'm not getting in the right position to do that. Those spikes they hurt too. Scurry monsters. Scary, like dangerous, or like the design would be a horrifying thing. Well, that sucks. That really sucks. That means I gotta dodge all the attacks. Alright, we're good. We go this way. Nice. Close. But no cigar game. Easy. I feel like that's some kind of weird bug. Oh, I could go for the strength or the swag strat. I don't know how to do it though. It looks really easy, but you boost off that thing. Oh no! Oh, we're fine. We're good. And you use an enemy attack to boost you up with extra speed. and you go up really quick. And I don't think it saves you any time, but it looks cool. I could be wrong about it saving no time. That, once again, I haven't timed anything. That, was it your first time streaming, Zach? I feel like I don't remember you ever telling me you streamed before. And if so, how did you like it? There's a quick way up this part, too. I don't remember how it's done whatsoever. Hey, we made it out of the glacial peak. And to the cool teller of time. Now, this area in my casual playthrough, I probably died 100 times. I don't know why. I don't know if it's hard. All I know is I was bad at this area. It requires a lot of patience. Like, you have to wait for platforms. And I was terrible at that. Alright, Tower of Time. So you gotta wait here. You can throw a shuriken at that. Pop up over here. I'm gonna hit the save point. Because I would be a fool not to. I made it through there. I really remember that section giving me a lot of grief, so. I think you do this. Oh. I mean, this section's really easy, no matter what. If you just hold right, you actually make it through. But there's a fast way to do it, too. Where you use the grappling hook. Whiz robes. I'm a monster. I'm killing them. Or at least. Oh no! Oh, I was like, oh no, I'm gonna get bashed! My Ubers came back to get me. They're like, oh, you beat the whiz robes. Well, we're gonna beat you now. We get zapped. I haven't died through here yet, and I've died at least like 20 times by this point in casual. Very nice. Now, do that. Grapple that. Some of these techniques I'm doing are making me wait a little bit extra long, but it's because I'm trying to make sure I do them the way that I can remember them being done in a speedrun. That wasn't how you do that part, though, I'll tell you that. You get this platform, it hung up at the top longer than I expected it to, and you glide down with it. And this one, you can... Oh, you have to jump. Oh, snap. I thought jumping was just people being stylish, to be completely honest, because I couldn't remember. You have to jump there. There are little divots on the walls. But you gotta jump at the right time. In case you were curious. There is a right time and a wrong time to do them. And a right height and a wrong height to do them as well. I wish I had another hit of health. That'd be cool. We're gonna hit the save point because dang did I die on that section a lot. I remember I died on this section a lot too. Speaking of dying. I missed the shot and I was holding forward. Oh my goodness. You gotta tap the button in the right way. I don't know what the pattern is. You gotta do a slow drift basically. You go too fast, hold the button too long, you hit the ceiling. If you don't hold it long enough, you don't go up. And you need to go down a little bit, and then you need to go up. That's the plan. At least this section's easy. That's the guy that walked into the laser. Oh man, I'm gonna need a practice this part. Yeah, got health. Which is good, because I needed it for that. I think there's another save point up ahead, though. So, get one chunk of health. Oh, and you... Oh, I don't have any points. You can throw a shuriken at that from a distance, and I believe it teleports you. All the way to it. Oh no, that's bad. This is a timed section. You have to hit these little jewels and then these ones to teleport you. And if you don't go fast enough, the laser door pops back on at the end. Where's Robes? Don't do it! I got scared there. Oh, we didn't get a save point? Oh man, okay. Hold right. Hold right. Hold right. Hold left. Hold left. Another hold left. Alright, and don't do anything. There we go, we made it through. Excellent. And I think we're at the laser room. Yeah. This part's not too bad. There's a save point right up here, which is great. And then there's this section. And I died on this little platform at least 30 times. Just being completely impatient. Now they're gonna go do the thing, and we're gonna try. We might get sub 1 hour. That's exciting. It depends on how well I do on this boss. I didn't do good casually, so maybe. There's a black bar going across my screen for some reason. I screwed up, but you're supposed to be able to use your grapple hook. In some fantastic way. I didn't do it right. I kind of did it right at the end, but I took a lot of the extra damage. Extraneous damage. The grapple, I call it the grapple, the rope dart, gives you a couple iframes when you do it, and you do the sword swing. So you can go through the energy orbs, and then if you time it right, you can kind of hit them and then bounce off and do it again and again and again. It's pretty cool. I'm hoping I get on this hand. Great. Champ! Sub 1 hour! Why do I have this bar going across my game? Is that in my stream too? Well, I can click away now and look. It doesn't look like it. Really weird. Like, it was one bar going straight across. Anyways, we got sub 1 hour. We got video proof that we got sub 1 hour. I'm pretty happy. We'll do this section just for